In Istio, you have two ways to perform an upgrade. You can do an in-place upgrade, or you can do a canary upgrade, where you deploy a second control plane with a different revision, and you slowly move your workloads to this new revision. This gives you a chance to test the new revision, and once everything is fine, you can get rid of the previous one. So before we do an upgrade itself, let's start by looking at the naming scheme that's used in Istio. If I look at the Gloo platform to see what Istio version that we already have, we have 1.16.3. So in this case, the major is 1, the minor is 16, and the patch is 3. So if I want to do a patch upgrade, for example, 1.16.3 to 1.16.4, I would do an in-place upgrade. And a minor upgrade would be going from 1.16 to 1.17. In that case, I would do a canary upgrade. And that's what we're going to demonstrate in this lab. So again, we have here 1.16.3. So I'm going to set some environment variables so that the old version is 1.16, and I want to go to the new version, which is 1.17. So once we set these variables, the same way we use the Istio Lifecycle Manager object to deploy Istio, we can also use it to perform these upgrades. We just update the existing applied lifecycle object that we've created for cluster one, and this part is exactly the same, but we're going to add a second part which corresponds to the second revision that we want to install. And the only difference is the new revision tag and the tag of the version that we want to use. So again, we're going from 1.16.3. So in this case, you can see here that we're going to 1.17. Yeah, 1.17.1. So when I apply this, what Gloo Mesh platform is going to do is it's going to deploy a new operator for the 1.17 in this 1.17 namespace, and it's going to create a new Istio operator object, the YAML, to represent the new installation of 1.17 revision. And basically, Gloo will configure these operators to automatically watch the Istio operator resources that are in the same namespace. So then the next step is the operator is being deployed. The operator will deploy Istio D1.17. So this mechanism is the same mechanism that you would follow for the gateways as well. We would deploy a new gateway with the new revision, and we do the same thing for the ingress gateway as well as the east-west gateway. And then we do the same thing for the Istio control plane on the second cluster, followed by the two gateways. So again, everything is done as code. So we defined that we want these two revisions to be deployed in the two clusters. It should be that simple. So if I go here, I can see that this gateway will be created very quickly because I already have the operator running. And I see the Istio, the ingress and egress gateway, everything is fine. And now I can go here and see that I have this operator being deployed as well. And now the gateways are created, so it would be very fast to deploy this new version. We can also check the status of each of these Istio operator lifecycle manager objects and the gateway lifecycle manager object. Each of them have a status field where you can see the different revisions across the different clusters and see if they're healthy and so on. So now that we've upgraded, what I want to do is restart the different pods that are connected to this control plane. So we want them to use the new revision Istio D. Over here, we can see all the pods that are across all the namespaces that are using this old revision. And I'm going to change the label of these namespaces and restart the deployments. So normally you'd probably relabel just the namespace of one test application, and then you would and you would restart the application and validate it works, and then you would kind of move on incrementally until you're happy with all of your workloads. And obviously you can definitely automate this incremental namespace upgrade process and testing. So here we're restarting everything so that everything's connected to the new control plane, which is revision 117. And this command here will give me a way to test access to the HTTP bin application that I've deployed in the cluster. And I've exposed this using the Istio ingress gateway. So basically I just need to check that this application can still be accessed properly. You can see we're getting a 200. Everything is up and running correctly. So everything is fine. But right now we're still using the old gateway, the gateway of the previous revision of the gateway, the 116 gateway, to expose this application. I can look at this gateway object here, and you can see that it's still using the 116 revision. So what I need to do now is I've moved my workloads to the new revision. I want to move the gateway to the new revision as well. And you can also do the opposite by starting by the gateway and finishing by the workloads. If you recall, we decided to create a service and for the ingress gateway that is not managed by the Gloo platform. And we did that so that we can reuse the same service, the load balancer service, and we can keep the same external IP as we upgrade Istio. And now all we have to do is patch that services so that they're now targeting the new revision. So I can simply patch this the way I, and we can check that everything is fine. And I can check that everything's working well with the new revision, and I can still access my access service correctly. And we've basically finished my migration because I don't have any more services or any pods that are connected to the previous revision anymore. There's also this convenient Istio CTL command that will list all the proxies that are connected to what specific version of the control plane. So that's another handy CLI. So when you're finished, you can now update these lifecycle manager objects. And we're just going to update it to remove all the old entries, all the old entries that are corresponding to the old revision of Istio. And what the platform will do is it's going to see that change, and it's going to automate the process of uninstalling, removing all of the components that are associated with the old revision. So you can see that the 116 control plane and the gateways that correspond to this 116 revision, and even uninstalling the Istio operator itself that was for 117. So all that's left is 117. And if you go back to the UI, you can see that it's all the new updates are reflected properly. I can see 117 and everything's healthy.